Good morning, dear students. Welcome to our online classes. Now I am in the 7th standard social study class. So in the previous class we already started a new lesson of the civics. Civics means political science. In that we already understand our defense forces. Our defense forces is one of the nice concept we have to understand in this class. So before we I am going to start this Indian Navy, that is before I am going to start the Indian Army, I am going to tell you something nice about the our defense departments. Here Indian defense forces contains three wings. How many wings are there? Three wings: the Indian Navy, the Indian Army, the Indian Air Force. So here the chief of the head of the Indian Navy, we have to consider as Admiral. Who is the present? Who is the present Admiral of Indian Navy? Karambir Singh. Just you have to understand. Who is the present Admiral of Indian Navy? That is none other than Karambir Singh. The second one is, the second wing is Indian Army. Indian Army head we have to call them General. Indian Army, the head we have to call them General. Who is the present General of Indian Army is Manoj Mukund Narvane. Present General of Indian Army is Manoj Mukund Narvane. Just have to understand. And the third wing is there, that is Indian Air Force. Who in the head of the Indian Air Force we have to consider as Air Chief Marshal. What we have to call the head? The head of the Indian Air Force is called Air Chief Marshal. Who is the present Air Chief Marshal of Indian Air Force? That is none other than Rakesh Kumar Singh Bhadauria. Rakesh Kumar Singh Bhadauria is the present Air Chief Marshal of Indian Air Force. So these are the three wings of the Indian Defence Forces. So these wings head we have to consider as CDS. CDS means what? Chief Defence Secretary. Chief Defence Secretary. Who is the present Chief Defence Secretary? Bipin Rawat. Bipin Rawat, that person is the CDS of the three wings. Who is the head of the three wings here? The President of India. So he appointed these people. One is CDS and the rest of three wings people and departments heads. So this is the brief information about our defense departments. Now it is the time to understand the Indian Army. It is the time to understand about Indian Army. Let's understand this sentence. The Indian Army is the second largest in the world. Though first one is, that is none other than USA, America. America has the American Army. The same manner here, Indian Army is the second largest in the world. So army comprises of three major groups. How many groups are there? Three major groups Indian Army has. The first one is infantry. Infantry. The second one is cavalry. The third one is tank regiments called armed groups. Gunners regiment are artillery. Artillery, infantry, cavalry, tank regimentary. So these are the three important groups of soldiers we have to understand in the Indian Army. So the next point is that there are 11 lakh soldiers at present in Indian Army. How much soldiers are there in Indian Army? At present 11 lakh. Just you have to remember that point in your memory. 11 lakh soldiers and 960,000 reserve forces in the army. There are main two categories are there in the Indian Army. The first one is reserve soldiers are BSF soldiers. The second one is reserve forces. The first one, BSF soldiers are 11 lakh soldiers are there. 11 lakh. How many reserve forces are there? 960,000. 60,000 reserve forces in our army. Understand? The next point is that the service chief of the army is called general. I already explained about that. The service chief of the army is called general. He is the responsible for discharging duties. Entire the Indian army responsible taken by the general. So, who is the present general of Indian army? Manoj Mukund Narvane. Just you have to note this point. Why? Because it is very precious for your GKR general knowledge. Have you understood about that? The next point is what is the main duty of this general? Here, the first one duty, he controlled the force. Entire Indian army he controlled, and he is the responsibility person of the Indian army. Then next one is, and he gives the training. He gives the training and he stopped the operations. Operations means here, not take the seizure and each and other things. That is not operation. Here operation means fight with others. That is considered as operation. So this is the responsibility of the general of the Indian army. And then the next one, last one point is there, that is the head office is based in New Delhi. Where is the head office of the Indian army? We have to find out. We have to find out the Indian army headquarters is located in our country. That is none other than the place of Delhi. So in the next one we have to understand. Well, Indian army helps to us. That is an important point we have to understand. The army has been rendering valuable humanity or humanization on us service during the natural calamities. What is the meaning of natural calamities? Now, recently, we are benefit from the COVID-19. In that time, they are very helpful. And next point, floods. When the floods at present we are watching in the TV news, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, some of the states of the North Karnataka place, especially in Kalburgi division, Kalburgi district, they are facing the what kind of floods. So in that places, these Indian army people help to the public order services. Given they are providing the services. So this is the brief information about Indian Army. So in the next class means we have to understand about the second wing of the Indian Defence Force is Indian Navy, and the third one is Indian Air Force. In the next class we have to understand both wings. Okay, thank you.